abundance. I am the source of my abundance. I focus on what I love and draw it to me. My thoughts are loving and positive. My dreams are coming true. I trust that the universe will always meet my needs. My energy is focused and directed to my goals. I am willing to accept the best life has to offer. I am open to opportunities. I honor myself at all times. I believe in unlimited possibilities.
My name is Caleb. I'm 7 years old, and my experience from the White House and Frederick Douglass's house was a great experience. I totally want to come here next summer.
Are you excited to be a part of the World of Money?
I'm excited? Yeah, I'm excited to be a part of the World of
Money. Why?
Why? Because I think it's a great experience and a life change.
So you're here on the World of Money show. What did you think about the White House?
Well, I thought it was a good experience because seeing it on TV is one thing, but actually coming seeing it is another thing.
Okay, and I think it's the White House tour is a good experience, not only for the adults, but for the children, and to expose them to the way our country is run and what goes on in making this country a great country.
You could see how the White House unfolds with history and modern times. It's beautiful, the scenery, the blue room, the green room, the red room, the dining room, and you could see presidents from historical times to President Barack today. And I think it was a wonderful experience with World of Money that org for us to visit the White House.
And we want to thank Ms. Sabrina Lam. She has done such an awesome work, you know, and we will continue to support her, you know, because this is exposure on the highest level for our children, you know, and just getting them in the world of money to handle themselves properly, you know, it's a great experience.
My name is Ryan Crow and I'm 9 years old. I had a fun experience today because I got to see a lot of great things in the White House and in the Capitol. In Frederick Douglass's, I think Frederick Douglass's garden is very nice, but very dangerous too.
Wake up everybody, no more sleeping in bed. No more backward thinking, time for thinking ahead. The world has changed so very much from what it used to be. There is so much hatred, war and poverty. Oh, yeah.
Learn.
Donate.
To what you have to say, cause they're the ones who's coming up, and the world is in their hands. When you teach the children, teach them the very best you can.
Oh. The message to that is follow your dream, follow your heart, do what's important to you. Never think about the money that you make in the process. Always think about what it is that you want to work on and what's meaningful to you personally, and everything else will follow.
Our money reality. We're going to address our parental archetype. What negative experience were you taught as a child? My name is Sabrina Lam. I always witness my mother stealing silver and putting it in her purse at great restaurants.
My name is Sandra Morris. My daughter is 17. She'll be attending a program. I have a 19-year-old. I'm trying to teach him something about money. I can't actually take his paychecks when he gets it and give him an allowance. So that's how I'm trying to teach him how to save. But my negative experience is, I think when I got into college, Hunter College, which was cheap and free, almost free because we got Pell and Tap, I asked my father for money for books, and he told me he couldn't give me that. All he could give me was some tokens. So my experience is that I have to do the best I can to make a future for myself because he couldn't provide that for me. So that's what I did.
I feel some emotion.
There's a lot of emotions. Feel some emotion.
I would say my problem growing up is that I always had what I needed. And that can be a problem. Let's face it, when you have what you need, there's no reason to think about saving money. I've always been the golden boy. I mean, I can do no wrong with my family. I do no wrong in society. I don't get chased around stores thinking I'm gonna steal things. You get this mentality that you're never gonna have to struggle or suffer, and that's probably been my biggest problem.
Today to teach these children at the behest of Miss Lamb, a true angel, somebody who got me involved in being able to share my background, my knowledge of finance with these kids. Sponges, just soaking up so much information, so interested. It is absolutely wonderful dealing with these young people. This has been a wonderful, wonderful experience, and I hope more people can become involved in worldofmoney.org and contribute both their time, their energy, and financial resources where possible. This has been a great experience. These kids are great. Thank you.
I believe the children are future. Teach them well and let them lead the way. Show them all the beauty they possess inside. Give them a...
I'm 35 years in industry, but I'm leaving here inspired about what these kids, what the future holds for these young people.
Children's laughter reminds us how we used to be.
My mother and father were never in my life. Me and my cousin used to collect bottles in the streets of Brooklyn. The thing you want to do in this world, no matter where you came from, what the color your skin is like, who you're around, what anybody tell you, including your family, who sometimes tell you you can't do things, but you really can. Anything you want to do in this world is possible.
To me, and so I learned to depend on me.
I'm a leader, not a follower, and I'm determined to change the course of my life and the lives of future generations to come.
Now that I experienced worldly money, I paid for a lot of my own things. I'm more knowledgeable about my financial environment and future. I started my own mutual fund. I have my own job. And I have my own business called Naive Arts, where I use my creative abilities to draw, paint, and sculpt, and then sell to interested people.
Ladies and gentlemen, if you can beat this bid, he just said $1,000.
Being successful is a selfish pursuit of resume building. Being significant is making a difference in the life of someone else. And your wonderful organization is clearly making a difference, a significant difference in the life of our future leaders.
I know that you're taught at World of Money to walk like you own the earth. Live like Sidney Lamb. Give back to the world far more than you take.
And so a portion of our proceeds every time we generate a sale goes back to an organization. And as of tonight, we are adding the World of Money to that list of organizations that we have.
I had a 7-year-old looking back at me saying, "Dad, I have to be involved in the World of Money."
I didn't say when I was a little girl that I wanted to run a nonprofit. You know, I wanted to write and, you know, in my work as a media commentator, that's what I wanted to do. But sometimes you make a plan and then you get a whisper, right? And I get a lot of whispers, but those I won't talk about. I was in attendance to a financial education seminar in 2005 for myself. And the whisper said, what if children were receiving the same information? So 6 months later was the first World of Money Financial Education Institute, and this is our 6th year. I had a plan to start the young mogul section this summer for ages 9 to 11. Well, that was until some 7-year-old showed up at the orientation. Said, Dad, I have to go. This is gonna change my life.